The English language is strange. Breaking a leg or getting knocked out is something most of us want to avoid. But we use positive phrases like break a leg and knock yourself out. And these are positive instructions? Are you confused? In today's lesson, I'm going to cover 20 funny and weirdly wonderful English phrases that are commonly used in everyday English. You can download the lesson notes and worksheet by clicking on the link below and entering your details. So let's get started. The first phrase is hold your horses. This phrase means wait a moment or calm down.
I know you're hungry, but hold your horses. I haven't finished dishing up yet and you need to wash your hands.
The best thing since sliced bread. This phrase means that something is very good or innovative.
This new toaster is the best thing since sliced bread. It makes perfect toast and can even boil an egg at the same time.
Next we have elephant in the room. This phrase refers to a problem or issue that everyone's aware of, but no one is discussing. Everyone is simply ignoring it or not talking about that most obvious thing.
Hi, Sarah.
Hi.
Is everything okay?
Yes, fine. I just wondered whether you had read this letter from Mr. Green?
No, I haven't.
Okay. Can we just address the elephant in the room for a minute, please? Why are you wearing a blue t-shirt on your head to work?
Oh, this. Sorry, I should have said when I came in. I had a little accident with the nose hair trimmers.
Next is couch potato. This phrase refers to someone who is lazy and spends a lot of time sitting on the couch watching TV.
I used to be a couch potato, but then I got up and I realised there's a whole world outside my living room.
Go bananas or go nuts. This phrase means to become very excited or angry and to let loose, release all your energy.
I've been on hold for 25 minutes. I'm gonna go bananas if they don't pick up soon. They cut me off!
Knock yourself out. Now, knockout can mean to be made unconscious, usually through an impact like a punch. A boxer knocks out his opponent. But if I tell you to knock yourself out, it means go ahead or do as you please.
Can I have some more pizza?
Yeah, knock yourself out.
I've got a bone to pick with you. This phrase means I have a problem or an issue that I need to discuss with you. It often suggests that you're in some sort of trouble.
Annabelle, come here. I've got a bone to pick with you. You ate the last of the ice cream and you didn't save me any.
Don't give up your day job. This phrase is used to tell someone that they are not very good at something. Be careful with this one as it may upset the listener to hear it.
Ah, I love singing in the shower.
Yeah, I heard you wailing in the shower this morning.
Oh, sorry, was I a bit loud?
Just don't give up your day job. Pardon my French. This phrase is used as an apology for using a swear word.
Oh, sorry I'm late. The traffic was a real pain in the Oh, pardon my French.
Put a sock in it. If you tell someone to put a sock in it, then you're asking them to be quiet or stop talking. It shouldn't be used in formal situations.
Shh, can you put a sock in it? I'm trying to watch this movie.
Lights are on, but no one's home.
This phrase means someone is not paying attention or they're not fully present.
I keep trying to explain to my teenage boy that he needs to put his laundry into the laundry basket if he wants me to wash it. But it's pointless. It's like the lights are on, but no one's home.
Drink like a fish. This phrase means to drink a lot of alcohol.
I imagine that his liver is very unhappy. He has a terrible diet and always drinks like a fish.
Next we have break a leg. Now this phrase is used as a way of wishing someone good luck, especially before a big performance.
Oh, I'll be in the front row watching you on stage. Break a leg, you're going to be great. Ooh.
Not playing with a full deck. This phrase means that someone is not quite sane or not very smart.
We should speak to the doctor about Dad. I don't think he's playing with a full deck. He just tried to put his shoes on his hands.
Keep your eyes peeled. This phrase means to be alert and watchful, to look out for something. Right, keep your eyes peeled. We are looking for the perfect picnic spot. Keep your shirt on. This phrase means to stay calm and not get too excited in an angry way.
Oh, I'm very angry.
Keep your shirt on. There's no need to shout. I'll show myself out. This phrase means to leave a place without waiting for someone to show you the way or without saying goodbye. Just see myself out. Don't worry about me.
I'm sorry to say that you've run out of cake. It was delicious. I will show myself out, shall I? Sorry for eating all your cake.
Up to my eyeballs in something. This phrase means to be extremely busy or overwhelmed with tasks.
Oh, I'm up to my eyeballs in work.
I'm practically swimming in paperwork. Fly off the handle. This phrase means to lose your temper or become very angry very quickly. She flew off the handle when I told her I'd eaten the last of her bananas. I didn't know they were her special bananas.
Cheesed off.
I love this phrase. Cheesed off. This phrase means to be annoyed or irritated. Like you're sniffing cheese.
I'm really cheesed off. They cancelled the concert and I was really looking forward to it.
Eat someone or something for breakfast. This phrase means to easily defeat or overpower someone or something. There's a funny line in the film Happy Gilmore where the bully says to the main character Happy, "I eat pieces of like you for breakfast." And Happy replies, "You eat for breakfast?
You better study for your algebra test tomorrow."
"Nah, algebra, smalgebra. I eat algebra for breakfast." Next, we shall hear these idioms in the context of a conversation. Idioms are important to learn if you're hoping to become fluent in English, as native speakers use them regularly. And if fluency is a real goal for you, then you should register for my free fluency masterclass. I've put a link in the description below.
How are things with your mum and Derek?
Oh, hold your horses. I need a cuppa before I talk about him.
Oh, what about a coffee instead? I have a new coffee machine and it is the best thing since sliced bread. Does a gorgeous cappuccino.
So how's things with you and your bloke?
Well, he's getting on my nerves, to be honest. He's become a bit of a couch potato these past few months. He's just been lounging around the house watching TV all the time.
Oh, really? Do you mind? Can we talk about the elephant in the room?
Huh?
Julie, come on. You aren't hiding it very well. You're pregnant, aren't you?
Oh, is it really that obvious?
Oh, so you are pregnant. That's so exciting.
Okay,
please don't go bananas about it. I've not got my head around it yet. I'm sorry I didn't tell you. It's been driving me up the wall keeping it a secret from you.
I bet.
Oh, do you mind if I put some more milk in my coffee? Oh, knock yourself out.
So I've got a bone to pick with you. Remember I asked you to keep the 3rd of March free so that we could do a spa day? Well, your mum told me that you're now booked to go to Wales that weekend.
Oh no, I totally forgot about your spa day. I'm so sorry. I'll keep my eyes peeled for another spa deal if you like. Please don't be cheesed off with me.
Don't worry.
So what are you planning to do in Wales? It's actually my cousin's hen do. I am dreading it because she drinks like a fish and, well, I won't be drinking at all, so I think I'll mostly be looking after her.
Your cousin Jane? Wow! Yeah, she can be a handful. Well, break a leg.
Who is she getting married to?
Young Fred from the post office. You know the guy? Lights on, but no one's home. Not sure if he's playing with a full deck. Do you know who I mean?
Oh, Fred! Holy shit!
Pardon my French.
He is such a pushover. Your cousin will eat him for breakfast.
I know, it's crazy, but they are in love, so... So my mum and Derek.
Oh yes, tell me.
So we were at a restaurant last week and my mum was humming along to a song that was playing in the background. Derek told my mum to put a sock in it, which I thought was a bit rude, but mum just laughed and said she loved singing, to which Derek replied, well, don't give up your day job. My mum flew off the handle, like screaming and shouting at him in front of everyone. I told her to keep her shirt on, but she stormed off. Then I had a heart-to-heart with Derek, who explained that he'd been up to his eyeballs in debt and really stressed out about it. Oh, it's all a bit of a mess, really.
Oh no, that's not good.
Oh, is that the time? I'm sorry, I've got to run. I'm late for work. I'll show myself out. I'll catch you later. Bye.
See ya.
Now it's your turn. Comment below using one of the idioms from today's lessons and boop the like button while you're there. Until next time, take care and goodbye.